Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Rohr. Topic covered here is constructing SLR parsing table. In this video, we are going to consider how to construct SLR parsing table for given context-free grammar. Learning outcome: at the end of the session, students will be able to find LR0 item for given context-free grammar. Simple LR, or in short SLR, is easiest to implement. We refer the parsing table constructed by this method as SLR table, and to an LR parser using SLR parsing table as an SLR parsing. A grammar for which an SLR parser can be constructed is said to be an SLR grammar. An LR0 atoms of grammar G is a production of G with a dot at some position of the right side. Thus, the production A derives XYZ yields the 4 atom. A derives dot XYZ. A derives X dot YZ. A derives XY dot Z. And A derives XYZ dot. The production A derives epsilon generates only one atom, A derives dot. An atom indicate how much of a production we have seen at a given point in passing process. For example, the first atom above indicate that we hope to see a string derivable from XYZ next on input. The second atom indicate that we have just seen on input a string derivable from X, and that we hope to see a string derivable from YZ. A collection of set of LR0 atoms is called as the canonical LR0 collection, and it is also a basis for constructing SLR parser. To construct the canonical LR0 atom, we define augmented grammar and two function, closure and goto. Augmented grammar: so if G is a grammar with a start symbol S, then G dash, the augmented grammar for G is with a new production rule S dash derives S, where S dash is a new starting symbol. The purpose of this new starting production is to indicate to the parser that it should stop parsing when the parser is about to reduce S dash derives S. The example of the grammar and the augmented grammar by adding the production E dash derives E is given here on the slide. The closure operation: if I is a set of LR0 atoms for a grammar G, then closure I is a set of LR0 atom constructed from I by the two rules. First rule: initially, every LR0 atom in I is added to the closure I. Second rule: A derives alpha dot B beta in closure I indicate that at some point in the parsing process, we might see a substring derivable from B beta as input. So if B derives gamma is a production, we also expect we might see a substring derivable from gamma at this point. Hence, we include B derives dot gamma in the closure I. We will apply this rule until no more new LR0 atoms can be added to the closure I. Example: consider the augmented expression grammar given here on the slide. If I is a set of one atom E dash derives dot E, the closure I contains the atom given here on the slide. Here, E dash derives dot E is put in closure of I by rule 1. Since there is an E immediately to the right of the dot, so by rule 2, we add E production with the dot at the left end, that is E derives dot E plus T and E derives dot T. Now there is a immediately T to the right of a dot, so we add the production with a dot at the left end, that is T derives dot T star F and T derives dot F. Next, F to right of a dot poses F derives dot in parenthesis E and F derives dot ID to be added. Now, no other atoms are put into the closure of I by rule 2. The closure operation algorithm is given on the slide. So, in this algorithm, if 1B production is added to the closure of I with the dot at the left end, then all B production will similarly add it to the closure. Kernel atom include the initial atom S dash derives dot S and all the atom whose dots are not at the left end. Non-kernel atom have their dots at the left end. So, each set of atom is formed by taking the closure of set of kernel atoms. The second useful function is goto. So, goto of I, x is defined to be the closure of set of all the atoms A derives alpha x dot beta such that A derives alpha dot x beta is in I. If I is a set of atoms given on the slide, then the goto operation for the terminal and the non-terminal of this grammar are given on this slide. Then we compute the goto of I, e by examining E for the atoms with E immediately to the right of the dot. So, such atoms are E dash derives dot E and E derives dot E plus T. So, we move the dot over the E to get E dash derives E dot E derives E dot plus T and then took the closure of the atom. So, closure of the E dash derives E dot is E dash derives E dot, while the closure of E derives E dot plus T is E derives E plus E dot plus T only as after dot there is terminal plus. In similar way, we compute the goto of the remaining terminal and the non-terminal. We now give the set of atom construction algorithm to construct the C, the canonical collection of set of LR0 atom for an augmented grammar G dash which is given here on the slide. Consider the grammar. An augmented grammar for this grammar by adding the production E dash derives E. I0 is a set of one atom E dash derives dot E. So, the closure I0 contains the atom given here on the slide and same is explained on the previous slide in the closure operation. We also compute the goto I0, E by examining I0 for the atoms with E immediately to the right of the dot in the goto operation which is I1. Then we compute the goto of I0, T by examining I0 for the atoms with T immediately to the right of the dot. So, such atoms are E derives dot T and T derives dot T star F. So, we move the dot over the T to get the E derives T dot and T derives T dot star F and then took the closure of this atom. We compute here goto I0, x, f by examining I0 for the atom with f immediately to the right of the dot. So, such atoms are T derives dot f. So, we move the dot over the f to get T derives f dot and then took the closure of this atom. Then we compute the goto of I0, left parenthesis by examining I0 for the atoms with the left parenthesis immediately to the right of the dot. So, such atoms are F derives dot in parenthesis E. So, we move the dot over the left parenthesis to get F derives left parenthesis dot E right parenthesis and then took the closure of this atom. We compute the goto I0, ID by examining I0 for the atoms with ID immediately to the right of the dot. So, such atoms are F derives dot ID. So, we move the dot over the ID to get F derives ID dot and then took the closure of this atom. Now, we consider the goto operation on I0 for all the terminals and the non-terminals. So, now similarly consider the goto operation on I1. Goto I1, plus is given on this slide which is I6. Go to I2 comma star is I7 atom. Go to operation on I3 atom is not possible. So consider go to I4 comma E, which is I8, and it is given here on the slide. Go to I4 comma T is I2. Go to I4 comma F is I3. Go to I4 comma left parenthesis is I4. Go to I4 comma ID is I5. Go to operation for I5 is not possible, so consider go to I6 comma T, which is I9. Go to I6 comma F is I3. Go to I6 comma left parenthesis is I4. And go to I6 comma ID is I5. Now go to I7 comma F is I10. Go to I7 comma left parenthesis is I4. Go to I7 comma ID is I5. Now go to I8 comma left parenthesis is I11. Go to I8 comma plus is I6. Go to I9 comma star is I7. Now the transition diagram of DFAD for this LR0 atoms are given on this slide. So till now we consider the LR passing algorithm, LR passing algorithm, that is SLR. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, find LR0 atoms for the following grammar. I hope all of you have completed this activity. So LR0 atoms for this grammar is given on this slide. Also the transition diagram for this LR atom are given on this slide. This is the reference used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.